After what I went through to win that limbo contest, I'm about to pry this out of my cold, dead hands.
Well, far be it from me to come between a boy and his trophy. All right, let me help you to bed.
Why is it those words lack their usual thrill?
Usual thrill? You've heard those before, huh?
Yeah, well, you fell for the oldest trick in the book. The damaged seventh lumbar routine.
Oh, gosh. Silly moi. All right, lead the way.
You know, I think I can hobble up there on my own, but thanks for bringing me home.
My pleasure. Thank you for a very unusual evening.
My pleasure indeed. I'll see you out. Ow.
Oh. All right. That's it. To the bedroom, I insist.
Well, I just love that authoritarian tone.
Come on. Grab your trophy.
Ooh, that's good. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Courtney.
Yeah.
Courtney, no. Listen to me. It's me, Joe. You were stung by a sea urchin. Do you remember?
No.
Listen, you were very sick. We were going to go get help on the raft. Do you remember any of that?
Some. Rest sounds good.
No, rest. Keep your eyes open. Look at me. Courtney, you need to stay awake, okay? I'm going to put some aloe vera on your foot, and then we need to get you to a hospital.
You know what I'm saying, Joe?
All right? Stay with me. This is going to hurt a little bit. I'm sorry. Bear with me. I'm almost done. Right there. There.
Thanks.
I wish I could do more.
You can't. John. Promise me. Promise me you'll look after Neil.
Hey, listen to me. We will both be able to look after Neil for many, many years.
It hurts.
I know.
So much.
I know. Listen to me. You need to stay with me, all right? Don't go anywhere. Courtney? Courtney, open your eyes. Listen to me. Listen to me. Neil needs you, okay? He needs both of us. Alive and well.
It hurts.
Wasn't it grand of Shotzi to provide us with this chopper?
Well, if it's as old as this light here, we're in trouble.
It's true, we could use a little night sight technology.
Joe could be right under here and we'd never see him.
Doing here?
We wanted to check on you.
Long time no see.
That'd be best if I stayed away.
You should have listened to your first instincts.
We were friends once. Just wanted to see how you were.
Not all that great. I believe Greg's lies when he told me he was my brother. I have no idea what's real anymore.
But you realize that you're not Marcia Cooper?
I figured that out when Greg tried to kill me.
That must have been a big shock to you.
I killed 5 people for that man. You can say that.
What Greg did to you was beyond evil.
I let him use me.
You were vulnerable and he took advantage.
I still killed 5 people. All the rationalizations in the world won't make that go away.
We're not trying to rationalize this. We're just trying to find some way to put one foot in front of the other. And I think that you should do that too.
Oh, did I ask for your advice?
No. You didn't.
Karen and I both realized that nothing can be figured out in one day, but we
Wait, yeah, sure it can. I've got it. Karen can give me a full frontal lobotomy that'll make me 100% better, and you two can break your arms patting each other on the back for fixing me.
We're not trying to fix you. We're just trying to help you in any way that we can.
Oh, great! Hi, I'm Julie Devlin, serial killer.
We know who you are.
And if you still give a damn about me, you're sicker than I am.
Frank, maybe I should go. Look, I have some family business to take care of, and when I get back, I could come see you again.
Don't bother. I don't want any more visitors. That includes you.
According to my calculations, we should be very close to the spot where we saw the campfire.
Oh, I wonder if that campfire was a mirage. The island looks deserted.
Well, let's walk along the beach and see if we can find any tracks.
Okay.
Somebody help!
What?
Joe!
Look!
Oh, my God, Joe! Oh, you are a sight for the sore spine.
Mom, Victor, how in this world?
You don't think we combed the cold looking for you? Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. But listen, Courtney is very ill, Mom.
What happened?
She was stung by a sea urchin.
Oh, good heavens. The Unimo species found in these waters can be quite deadly.
She isn't going to shock.
Well, there's not a moment to lose, Mary. Go back and gather some of those yellow blossoms from that bush that we just passed.
May I ask why?
It's calendula. It makes an excellent poultice when crushed.
Listen, I already cleaned out her wound the best I could. What she needs now is a systemic treatment.
Perhaps you would respond well to a tea made out of grape seeds.
You know what, you're right. Grape seeds should work.
With any luck, we might be able to find an arbor on this island.
Well, yeah, this sounds fine, but shouldn't we get her to a hospital?
Oh, no, sure this will be successful. I've seen it work before.
Listen, it's worth a shot. I don't think Courtney can make it to a hospital. I saw some grapes on the ridge back there. I'll go collect some.
I'll get the calendula.
Okay, listen, there's a gourd on the fire back at the campsite. You can use it to heat water. I'm going to take her back to the campsite, and then I'm going to get some grapes.
Let's hope that the grapes are ripe enough for the seeds to be potent. Let me give you a hand. Okay, I'll wait here for Mary, and I'll join.
All right.
Oh, boy.
I got you. Oh, watch your foot. Look at all these books. Oh, watch out. There's a book on the floor right there. Step right over
it.
Watch that one. There's a big one.
I got it.
Kevin, have you ever heard of bookshelves?
Well, I like surrounding myself with knowledge. Besides, I do my best thinking in this room.
I'll bet you do. All right, wait. Let me flip some of these.
No, Eve, really, it's not necessary. You don't have to do that.
I want to.
All right.
Here. I'll make it all nice and comfy for you. There. Okay, now get in there.
Oh, well.
Oh, better?
Oh, that's like a regular throne.
Well, after all, you are the limbo king.
And don't you forget it.
Let me put this over here. Right here on this table so you can gaze at it lovingly.
I don't suppose you could bring it closer. I can't touch it over there.
Anything for my king. There you are.
Thank you.
All right, let me clean up some of these books.
No, really, Eve, that's not necessary. You don't have to do that.
Listen, Kevin, if you get up in the middle of the night and you trip over these books, there won't be anyone here to help you. Ooh, wow, case studies on schizophrenia. A little light reading, huh?
Well, it makes me feel healthier by comparison.
What else have you got down here? Oh, what's this? Huh. What is this?
Well, you have one of my biographies there?
Not quite. Let's see. I think I'm going to have to read you a bedtime story.
Maybe I should wait for you in the hallway.
Finally! Progress!
Bye, Julie. I'll check to make sure our flight to Greece is on time.
I know you're scared, but I'll see to it that you get all the attention you need.
I tried to kill your brother, Frank. I tried to kill Joe by sticking a sword in him. I almost blew up your mother in an elevator. Any of this sounding familiar?
No one is denying that you did terrible things, but the responsibility isn't all yours. Cooper had a hand in it, and I even played a part. If I had found you sooner when Cooper kidnapped you a year ago, none of this would have happened. All these months, I should have seen that you were in trouble sooner.
What, you feel guilty? Think you should have been the macho man who protected the little woman?
Guilt is not the reason I'm here.
But is the baby keeping you here? If so, you should know I lied about that. I was only using you to get me out of jail.
Yeah, I figured that one out already.
But why do you still care?
Let's just say I don't think it's fair the way your life turned out. It shouldn't have happened. And I think somebody should give you a hand.
I don't want anything from you. Not your pity, and not your help. Don't visit me again. Guard, I'd like to go!
I think we've got enough grape seeds. We'll let it steep until the tea is ready.
The fever is spiking. We need to make this happen as soon as possible.
Well, I'm sure it'll be successful. I've seen it work before.
Yeah, which part of the flower do I smush to make the pulp?
The petals.
You are such a fine gent to be marooned with.
Yeah, what is it with these survival skills?
Well, I could tell you, but then,
well,
of course...
you'd have to kill me, right?
Something like that. Your own survival skills are nothing to sneeze at. You've done a fine job keeping body and soul together here.
Well, I'm no closer getting Neil back from the Canellas.
You must be so worried about it.
Yeah, I don't even want to talk about it. I could punch my fist right through a wall.
See, that's why there aren't any buildings on this island.
The first batch of tea is ready.
All right, here, I'll raise your hand.
All right.
Don't let it get too hot.
No, it's not.
Easy.
Okay. There you are. Just drink a little bit. Oh, good girl. Good girl.
Now, the poultice is ready whenever you want.
All right, listen, Mom, we'll apply it in the helicopter. I think the tea should make her stable enough to get her to mainland. And Victor, what can I say? You are a lifesaver.
Let's save the compliments until we're actually saved.
Let's get in.
All right. Here. Let me give you a hand here.
Can I help?
Yes. Take this.
I will.
Okay. Here we go. Good. Here we go. Right this way. You got the place,
I got the place.
All right. Good.
Ah, there we go.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Now, where were we?
What is making you smirk like that?
The Complete Poems of Emily Dickinson. Boring case study, huh?
No, I was getting in touch with my feminine side.
I'm sure you were. You know, this book just happened to open to a certain page. Shall I refresh your memory?
Be my guest.
Wild nights, were I with thee, wild nights should be our luxury. Futile the winds to a heart in port, done with the compass, done with the chart. Rowing in Eden, ah, the sea, might I but moor tonight in thee. Pretty hot stuff for a Victorian, huh?
You know, all of a sudden I'm not sleepy at all.
Well, maybe I should go back to a boring case study.
It's too late. I'm wide awake.
Maybe I should dim the lights. There. Now maybe you'll get sleepy. May I use this to read by?
What's mine is yours.
There we go. Maybe I should go back to something more soporific.
You think so?
Oh! Oh, what's wrong? What's wrong?
Oh, poor baby. Oh, no, I'm fine. It's like heat-seeking missiles going up my spine.
Oh, man. Is there anything I can do for you?
Actually, there is, but I hate to ask.
Come on, Kevin. We've been held hostage together. You can ask me anything.
All right, I don't want you to take this the wrong way. I mean, there's no subterfuge in this request at all, but I really could use a massage.
I just saw Julie in the hallway. She wouldn't look at me. So what happened?
She told me to take a hike.
So much is going on with her right now. I guess she just can't deal with people.
Yeah, well, that's fine for everyone else, but I am the one person who's stuck by her through this whole damn mess.
Do you think she owes you something?
I don't know what I think.
You know, Julie's mind is in a million pieces right now, and I don't know how it works, but I'm pretty sure there's not a lot of rational thought going on. Who knows what's motivating her? It could be guilt, could be shame, anything, really.
No, the Julie that I knew is gone. There's only this shell of her left.
She needs care that we can't give her. All we can do is leave her to the doctors, undo some of the damage. I mean, maybe they can reach her.
If there's anything left to reach. Yeah.
Frank! It's Victor Collins!
Victor? Where are you?
In a helicopter. There's someone here who wants to speak to you. I'll patch him through.
Hey, so what'd you get me for Christmas anyway?
Joe, you little jerk. We were beginning to think you were fish food.
Joe, let me speak to him. Come on.
No such luck. It is so good to hear your voice, man. Listen, you wouldn't happen to know where Karen is, would you?
Yeah, I sure do. Hold on.
Joe, is it really you?
Hi, sweetheart. Do you miss me?
I missed you so much. How are you? Are you okay? Where's Neil? Do you have him yet?
I'm fine. We haven't found Neil yet, but we know where he is.
I've been so worried about you.
I cannot wait to get home to you.
Oh, please, make it soon.
Absolutely. I love you, Karen.
Oh, I love you too. I love you so much. I miss you so much. Joe, I knew you'd save me.
Oh.
How did this feel?
Words fail me.
I take it that's good.
Oh, that's very good. You know, that's good, I think. You can stop now.
Are you sure? Because I'm not really tired.
No. It's not that. It's just... I think if you kept going, I don't think I could take any more.
Okay, well, then I'll send you my bill in the morning.
You know, in case no one's ever told you this, you have an unbelievable pair of hands. Soft, yet strong. Just think of all the lives they've stitched back together.
Oh, yeah, the OR. Now that's romantic.
Are we talking about romance?
Us? No. Mm-mm.
Well, you brought it up. Give it another thought.
Oh, no, are you okay?
Yes, but... No, I'm not.
I told you needed to behave yourself, Dr. Collins.
Well, it's difficult to do with you here, Dr. Lambert.
Then I think I should leave. Is there anything you want before I go?
Yes. You?
Not in your condition.
this isn't the way I expected the evening to turn out, you know.
Well, Kevin, tomorrow is another day.
I'll keep that in mind.
You do that. Good night, Dr. Collins.
Good night, Dr. Lambert. Thank you.